Gracious host, CEO Ro. Of course, we got another banger today, man. The train is rolling hot. You feel what I'm saying? I met this individual a long time ago in my cast studio days. You all know about that. Ever since I met him, he's always been great energy. We've been looking for ways to work. We were looking for ways to work then. You feel what I'm saying? And connect and see what we can do to, you know, fuck y'all up out here. You feel what I'm saying? So we finally got to start. You dig what I'm saying? To get my man to come on the show, get in his business, let everybody know what he's been doing, what he's getting into, and what they can expect from him for 2023 and beyond. With no further ado, man, let the people know who's on the CEO Ro Experience today.
Hello. Wow, this is funny. I like this. This different. Yeah. This different from being on the radio, even though we on the radio live every Thursday from 7 to 9. But, you know,
the plug.
It's your boy Free Truth Ray, aka Mr. Rose Certified Clothing. I have the first official clothing brand of the cannabis community. Most people have cannabis apparel. I have a brand. I have the Bong Bunny. I have a Bud Bunny. I have Plants Over Pills. We in Philadelphia, where Frankfurt is probably the worst place in America, you know what I mean? And we want to get the perks and the zannies out the young people's hands, so, you know, got the Plants Over Pills even for the people that don't smoke. I have autistic children, so we do autistic awareness with Rose Certified Clothing. I have a boy bunny and a girl bunny.
We here, we support autism. And autism awareness here on the CEO Ro Experience. I too have a child that has autism.
How about, there we go. So now we going to work even more after this, knowing that, because we have autistic children. And, you know, a lot of people have autistic children, but they really be like keeping that to themselves. You know what I mean? And I tell my son, I say, ain't nothing wrong with you. You special and, you know what I mean? You autistically smart. My son's, he's a sponge. So, right. You know, when people teach him something, he get it. He be learning stuff faster than I do. You know what I mean? So I let him know ain't nothing wrong with you just because, you know, somebody, you know, put a label on you. But at the same time, we going to take that label and uplift it. You know what I mean? So, yeah, that's what we going over there.
That's what's up, man.
You know what I mean?
That's real dope, right, man? And anything that, you know, I can do or we can do here at the CEO Ro Experience, man, to help you along with that mission. You know, let me know. I'm with it. You already know I'm down.
Oh, no. After this, I'm going to get your size. That way, when you do the CEO Ro Experience joint, you're going to be sitting here with your next guest or whatever, right, or one of them autism joints on. You know what I mean? That's how you support me.
No doubt.
You know what I mean? You rock it on your show.
Yes, sir.
You know what I mean?
But before we get started, man, I got to give a big shout out to my guy, man, DJ Weird Nasty on the ones and twos. You dig what I'm saying? You already know. You know what I mean? He's here. You know what I'm saying? To add to the experience, man, and again, you are appreciated, brother. Make sure, or matter of fact, no, fuck that, making sure. Let them know real quick, you know, where they can find you at and what you got going on, bro.
Oh, wow. All right, y'all can follow me on Instagram at DJ Weird Nasty. Every Monday and Wednesday, CEO Ro Experience, and every Tuesday, Day with MF Day.
Okay.
On Feed Second Market. Mm-hmm. So, be on the lookout. Also, I have an album out, just reached 100,000 plays.
Keep working. Don't forget, you can find him at His and Hers Lounge on South Street on any given Sunday or any given day.
Sunday and Thursdays.
Sundays and Thursdays.
He working out here.
So he's working, you know what I mean? Shouts out and salute to my guy, DJ Weirdnet. Something else, bro? Okay, all right. Shouts out to my guy.
CEO Row Experience every
Every Monday and Wednesday. You can find him here, man, rocking with me, man. Of course, we can never break tradition. We're here at the CEO Row Experience, create a signature drink on behalf of our guests. You dig what I'm saying? That's our way of giving flowers and, you know, showing a little bit of appreciation for, you know, coming and kicking it with us, man. Today, man, we got the vodka crayon for my man. Yeah. Truth Ray. You dig what I'm saying?
Now,
clap that up. We got the vodka crayon for my man, Truth Ray.
Now, you dig what I'm saying? I ain't even no I ain't no drink boy. You know what I'm saying?
Listen.
You know, if I said that correctly, because, you know, outside of the clothing,
right.
You know, I'm half of Gas Station Radio.
Right.
Have the only cannabis education radio show on FM radio in the world, not just in the city, the state, the whole world. You know what I mean? Nobody is on FM radio talking cannabis education. Everybody that you see talking about cannabis is on a podcast. You know what I mean? And, you know, they can smoke on podcasts. We, you know, we got to follow the FCC regulations, but, you know, we definitely have a platform in which, you know, anybody that has a business, they could come on. You know, mainly it's cannabis, so we go to a lot of cannabis events, me and Lady Steph, and we try to get a lot of cannabis vendors on and to really educate people on cannabis, not the thinking. I was somebody who did the corner thing, so a lot of people think that's what it is, and it's definitely not that. And, you know, because of knowing that, that's how I got a radio show, you know what I mean? Every Thursday, 7 to 9, WJYN 98.5. We do something called the 8th at 8, where at 8 o'clock we play underground music in the city, try to give you know, people a shot. When I listen to other stations, they always playing the same songs all the time. So when I meet young artists and I say, if your music radio ready, or go to your engineer and get the radio edit, send it to me, and I really play it so they can ride around. Yo, call your mom, call this person, call that person. Everybody that rap wanted to hear their song on the radio.
Right.
Before Instagram and all that, you wanted to hear your song on the radio. So anybody that I meet, I say, yo, give it to me, call them up. Yo, I'm playing your song. Go sit in the car. Go that way, your mom and your dad really hear your song on the radio. They really gonna drive you to the studio next time. Or they really might, you know, oh snap, he was really on there. And, you know, actually,
bing bong,
you know, participate in your life, you know what I'm saying? Right. And actually, you know, motivate you or the people that's around to, you know, believe in you, not be like, oh, snap, he corny.
Right.
You know, you not corny as soon as they hear you on the radio. I don't care what nobody say, so I play everybody music. You know what I'm saying?
So real quick, I got to stop you. I understand that you smoke. I smoke. I am a 420 friendly individual. You know what I mean? I'm with the gas. You already know this.
Yeah.
But this drink is signaturely created.
Just for me. All right. Well, how open this?
Now hold on. You gotta get your straw. Hold on. We don't want to.
Yeah, man. I'm about to discombobulate something. You know what I'm
saying? But you gotta get a straw. Can we get you a straw right here?
Yeah, man.
I thought it was one already on there, brother.
No. But at the end, and I ain't touch it.
Like I stated, we created the vodka crayon for my man Truth Ray. That's the name of it. Vodka crayon for my man Truth Ray.
Yeah.
It's vodka and cranberry. It has lime, lemon,
okay,
and orange fruit inside of it, brother.
Okay.
You dig what I'm saying?
Thank you. Okay.
For it to be named after, you have to finish drinking it before the end of the show.
I got
to
drink a whole yam talking about? Yeah. I don't even drink like that, though.
I don't drink like that neither. You a big boy. This is juice mixed with liquor. It's not straight. You dig what I'm saying? You stick your straw right up there on top.
I'm glad I ain't driving.
That's a good thing. Stick your straw in there. You can seal it back. You dig what I'm saying?
Oh, man. And I got to just talk to you with the joint ski?
Yeah, no, cheers. Cheers, brother. Cheers.
All right. All
right,
man.
Cheers.
Oh, man.
There you go. Man, we official now. We official. There you go.
All right, so now that I got my drink, I can still, because you know, yeah, I mean, you got me on the show. Like, I be doing a whole lot. You know what I'm saying? You know, we got clothing, we got radio, and I got a TV show on Roku TV.
There we go. So that's why I wanted to first.
Hey, you know what you got?
Hey, Weird, we know what you got to do, Weird. Mm-hmm. Miss all love, man. Shouts out to DJ Weird Nash.
I can't share it. I can't share this joint with my who I came with.
Can share. I mean, it's for you. Got to finish it. It's not for she. We got a joint for your queen anyway. In a minute.
But getting back, this is shared situation.
Listen,
this is an equal opportunity joint.
So listen, right. We want to know truth before you get too fucked up and we get too far off of the interview. We want to know, when did you decide you were going to take Gash Radio and all your other ventures and say, look, I'm running. I'm going to give it to the people. This is what I'm passionate about. This is what I want to do. Can you take us to the start of when you started to establish your whole entity and legacy when it comes to media?
Okay. Dang, and we're going to keep it a bean. My lady, she was starting a podcast with some people, right? They was talking about cannabis and stuff. Okay. And me being all newsy because I'm, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. I'm like, well, what y'all talking about? Why y'all this and why y'all that? And me, you know, asking why this and why that and why that, you know what I mean? And I thought whatever they doing wasn't making sense. And then what ended up happening is that didn't work out. And then me and her started talking about, you know, well, this is what you gonna do. We might as well do it like this or do it like that. Right. So, you know, when you be smoking, when people get high, they just be saying they gonna do stuff, right? They just be, they be dreaming. But we actually was smoking and then it was like, all right, we gonna start a podcast and then we gonna actually get a logo. And then next thing you know, we had little mics on us like this and we sitting outside, the wind blowing the tripod on the, you know what I mean? We had to find days where the wind wasn't blowing and all that. We ain't know what we was doing. But she took me to DC, right?
Okay.
And I went to my first cannabis event. Mm-hmm. So I walked into a room and it was like all this weed. And I was looking around and I just was like, I wasn't thinking positive.
Okay.
And I was like, Lord Jesus. Like, I wasn't thinking positive. Right. And so, she. So she like, no, not me. So she, like my I was just blown out the, you know what I'm saying? It was just too much going on.
Right.
It was weed everywhere, it was different types of this, that, and people had rolled, yo, what's this, what's that? It was, people was dabbing, and it was too much going on for somebody who only knew about tree from copping it from your man, come through, bust it down at the table, and then go to the, you know what I'm saying? So I was like, and how they get on?
They took it legal for you, so they blew your mind when you seen that they could set up and legally sell weed at these, I would assume a pop-up?
Yeah, it was like a pop-up, and I just was like, man. I wasn't thinking right. I was like, man.
Yeah.
Me and my man's in them, boy.
Right. Well, as you know, and I can attest, I have, you know, I've run a situation where they've come to rent the space. I don't think nobody... You had to be like the 18.
No, listen, man.
I'm just being honest.
No. You really would be, but what I'm saying is...
We're securing the premises.
No, but you asked me what... You did, you know what I'm saying? I didn't do it.
Yeah. We don't want to go right.
But my brain was mapping it, though.
Right.
Ain't nothing like it when a good plan come together, like the 18.
But obviously, a good plan did come together, right?
Because I was like, what? You know what I mean? I was learning.
Right.
You know what I mean? So I'm like, man. I'm like, yo, I got to bring my mans in them down here, like my good friends, not the bad friends.
Right.
I'm like, yo, I got to bring my homies down here. They got to, because if I tell them about this, I feel like, you know, when you got your homies and y'all smoke good, y'all call, yo, I got the good, but I felt like I did something
wrong
without my
good
homies.
Okay.
Like, yo, y'all should have been with me.
You felt you deceived them a little bit.
Yeah, like, yo, y'all can't even believe what I saw. Right. So, yeah, after seeing that, it was like, yo, like my lady, she was all like, she just all heavily educated and she just was knowing about this and that and that. And I just was, you know, I'm smoking, just listening. You know what I'm saying? I don't know nothing.
Like, all we could do this, we could do that.
All I know is the weed green and it smell good.
Right.
And all right, I'm selling it. That was it.
That's it.
I ain't know about no sativa, no indica, no hybrids, no CBD. I ain't know about none of that.
So your woman educated you past what you've already known. Or what you've known for so long as it pertains to weed.
Yeah, I'm going to say that. I'm going to keep it 100. Yes.
Okay.
Yes, I can't lie.
And then, no doubt. So from that point, we're going to go ahead and what did we start first? Did we start Gash Radio? Did we start Roll Certified?
So that everything kind of started, like the ideas was spewing at the same time. Mm-hmm. So yeah, Gas Radio and Roll Certified kind of came both at the same time. And then it was like, all right, we're going to do this podcast where we're going to talk about, you know what I mean, and how we're going to do it or whatever. Then it was like, all right, we're going to think of a clothing line. Then we got to think of a logo. Then, you know, we had to find a logo guy and, you know what I mean, an idea and then all that. You know, like, it took a long time before it got to this right here.
I
got the LLC. I got a trademark.
Right.
Yeah. You know what I mean? Before all that, it was just the idea.
Right.
You know what I mean? And that was the dope part about life, of actually, like, having an idea and like, seeing it through. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Like, I ain't never really seen nothing through in my life. I ain't, you know what I mean? I went to school. I wasn't trying to be no college person or nothing.
Right.
Had a job and did, you know what I mean?
We appreciate you sharing that and being honest with
us. Yeah,
is like the first thing you've done that since school that you see yourself.
Yeah, like I wasn't basketball.
I'm
went to Gretz.
Right.
I went to Gretz.
Okay.
But I ain't played ball with Ellerby. All the ball I played was outside on the court. You know what I mean? I felt like I was better than y'all, but I ain't wanna go to practice. You know what I'm saying?
It's all good. Practice.
Yeah,
practice.
You know what I mean? So like this is actually like the first, and it's legal. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Like, I ain't, you know, I did illegal stuff. You know what I'm saying? So that's the only thing that was focused my brain on, was I always had to keep a job so my mom and my dad and whoever could be like, my son work here. But when I got off work, I was with my mans in it.
No doubt. Can we put a year on? We got to put a year on when you established it. When did it become official?
I don't know. I'm gonna say 2019.
Okay.
The last 4 years.
Yeah.
Like once we started it, everything I did in my life, I've like people look at me like, you know, family and friends. If you know me, then it's like if I do something, I gotta do it. Otherwise, it's like people be talking, right? So, and then I'm somebody that if you be BSing, I'm the first that's gonna tell you it. You know what I mean? So I got a lot of people that when I started, when I'm doing it, was like, oh, you trying to be like everybody else, or what you think, you Gilly and Wallow, and you know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And it's like, I'm doing something that they not doing, or nobody's doing what I'm doing. Mm-hmm. So I feel good about that, you know what I mean? I was like, and I'm 42, you know what I'm saying? So I ain't want to be on social media. I'm not, like, my friends think I'm funny, but I ain't doing nothing funny on social media. I'm not doing that.
You're not the funny guy.
Not on the camera.
Yeah, copy. I'm not, don't make me the big, copy.
Yeah, off the camera.
Yeah.
Like, I hang with comedians. Yeah. I'm cool with a lot of comedians. They be like, when you gonna get on stage, whatever. I'm like, no, I'm cool. I might gotta be mad drunk to do it.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? But I ain't doing it. I mean, I don't know. Right. I don't know. You know what I'm saying?
Who knows what the future may hold? For
yeah, man, I might because I be hearing comedians. Sometimes I don't went to the comedy shows. I'm like, yo, I'm better than Bull.
You better than Bull. I'm better than Bull.
Yeah, I didn't say I'm better than Bull. And my homies be like, won't you just get up there? And I'm like, no. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. No, I ain't doing that. You know what I'm saying? So
yeah, maybe that's something that you can explore in the future. You dig what I'm saying? So how did we take it? Did we immediately jump into radio?
No. So what happened was because. When we went down DC, it was like, yo, they don't got this in Philly. So what happened was, my lady found, an event to go to in Philly. It was called, Laughing High with my man Buzzy.
Okay.
So we go to Laughing High and they had the comedians and they had the cannabis vendors and all that. Mm-hmm. They ain't have as many as they did down DC. They had like 2-3 balls, but it was cool though.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? It was like, oh shit,
yeah.
Okay. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, a little situation.
So we did that, and then what happened was, after that comedy show, the boy Buzzy, he was doing the recap, so I tapped in. Mm-hmm. And I like, yo, man, I wanna, me and my girl, we got a podcast called Gas. Yo, I wanna sponsor that joint.
Right.
So he's like, oh, you wanna be a sponsor? So literally, like, the next 10 comedy shows that he had after that, we sponsored them. Mm-hmm. Like, we would, you know, put to a comedian or whatever, and then we would go, and then that's kind of how, like, we start meeting a lot of comedians. Mm-hmm. We start meeting different vendors, and then, you know, from meeting different vendors, then we start going to their events, and everything kind of, like, But we started off with the comedians, you know what I mean? So, you know, Buzzy.
Shouts out to Buzz. Buzz Taylor, correct?
Sha Santiago.
Yeah. Sha.
You know what I mean? My man Beast, they got us the show.
Right.
Comedian Body. Del Gold, Mike Salvi.
Right.
You know what I mean? The Chichia, Molly Cobain.
Copy.
A million of them, bro. Yeah. Like, he had everybody.
Tour. Right, you went on the comedy tour.
Yeah, we had everybody. So that's we got started with the comedians.
Right. I just think it's dope because it just you just came alive. Just talking about just that whole experience in itself,
yeah.
And how, you know, I see that was something new for you. It inspired you. It motivated you to want more from it. You feel what I'm saying?
Well, like you know how people be looking on the Instagram, right? And they be having all the people, we having all the followers and all that, and it's like I be noticing like. Them people be having a lot of followers. They regular boys behind the scenes. Know what I'm saying? So, like, I'm always outside. So, it's like, I ain't afraid to be, you know, so, like, to be around the people, actually be talking with them, smoke whatever. And it's like, man, I got 1,000 followers on my Instagram.
Right.
Man, got like a 20, 30, you know what I mean? But, like, these dudes regular bulls, you know what I'm saying? So like, I started, you know, like, oh, all right.
You could do this.
I could do this because I used to think I was bull.
Right.
So in my head, if I'm 100 with who I feel I am,
right.
Then I don't.
And these are my peers.
Yeah, but like, I'm a good person, right? I'm a good father.
Go ahead.
I'm a good father. I'm a good friend. Good boyfriend. You know what I mean? Right. Right? I'm a man first, right? Mm-hmm. So, I can stand with any man. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. So when I go in rooms, it's like I'm free to right, guys. You see how I carry it when I'm outside. It's right. When I don't feel like nobody, there's nobody in a room bigger than me.
Mm-hmm. And there's nothing wrong with that, bro.
Because I feel like you don't know who I know, you don't know what I did.
Yeah. Right.
You don't know me.
You don't know me.
For real.
Right.
And no, if you did know me, yeah. Then you would understand why I carry myself with such
confidence.
Yeah. Now I do carry myself with a certain humility. You know what I'm saying? I will show you my tech. Mm-hmm. Because when you really bull, you really patient and humble.
No doubt, no doubt.
Too much is given, much is required, you know what I'm saying?
No doubt. You already know, man. It's a lot of responsibility and accountability that comes with that. You feel me?
Yes.
And again, brother, I appreciate you coming on the CEO Role Experience and kicking it with us, man.
Yes.
I'm definitely having a good time. We got to go pay some bills and show some love. But before we go and do that, beloved, let the people know where they can find you at.
Yo, so listen, you can find me at Free Truth Ray. That's the regular page. That's where I do business. I have fun. If you're a person who you take social media serious, then I need you to follow me at Roll Certified and at g.a.s.underscore radio. You know what I mean? Gas Radio, because that's where all the business at. We got the radio page. We got the clothing and the TV page. So if you strictly business, go to Roll Certified Gas Station. But if you want to smile and laugh at the memes that I ain't make them, they made them. I just reposted them. And follow me on Free Truth, bro.
No doubt, man. No doubt. Thank you again, bro, for sliding in to the CEO Role Experience, man. We'll be right back with my guest, Free Truth Ray. Take us out, DJ Weird Nasty.
Yo, what's poppin', man? It's your boy, New Jersey Twerk, man. I'm fucking with DJ Weird Nasty. DJ Weird Nasty dropped that ill shit, so I already know Jersey.
Rainy day, the black and white, I live my life in gray. sipping, reminiscing on your loving. Slowly sipping, reminiscing on your loving. Slowly sipping, reminiscing on your loving. My RX ain't an RX, but it helps get rid of the stress. Can easily find another one, but I promise never settle for less. Now I'm staring in this fair view, and my own eyes pretending they're yours. Steady thinking about you, thinking about you. They say a shot a day keeps the pain away, and the sun it shines through a rainy day. Through the black and white, I live my life in gray.
Freedom, Freedom Thinkers Academy, we in the building. Early. That's right. Wanna hurt that's nobody. Right. I don't wanna hurt nobody. I don't wanna hurt nobody. The Thinkers, nigga.
Respect my hand. Let's go hard. Respect my pen work.
What up, A?
You already know what it is. Lady Sparks up next. I don't give a fuck if that is your type,
no,
but we already know who I am. Let's rock.
You heating up, Lavish?
Shorty, she okay, but you know that I'm pressure. I ain't sweating no nigga shit, I let it burn like Usher. If you feel like that grass greener, then go with her. Cause I don't do disrespect, low tolerance. Let me get this understood, I'm the same bitch that wrote for you. I crossed the border, shit, I could've did a bid with you. I used to miss the times, man, what I bid with you. Now you rubbed off, nigga, I can't bid with you. You ain't the same, man, you done switched up. You got me fucked up, and then out my life, yeah, you got me fucked up. Next bag off of shit, I might luck up. Yeah, she hot, go here and go and manage ya. Y'all know Sparks hit the stage, ain't no amateur. I send shots, don't give a fuck who it aim at ya. Don't like what I said, nigga, better do something. Never do I cop a plea, I go duck hunting. Fucking every beat like I'm making love or something. Is that your dog, man? Watch how I train the bitch. She acting hard, man, watch how I tame the bitch. Bring her through the hood, let my niggas train the bitch. Tired of your fake shit.
Fake shit, bitch-ass niggas.
Look, dear diary, my pride getting the best of me. I done heard smart remarks from the ones that was next to me. See, isolation is the key. You gotta think of a greater plan if you're trying to get rid of me. See, I awake. Even when I'm asleep, I'm at peace. Think of greatness when you speak of me. Listen closely, you wonder why I keep my kids close to me. Cause I was raised by creeps. Late nights used to fight in my dreams. Image of that bastard touching me. Never knew that he was bringing all the pain to me. Bring me stranger things. He would tell my mom anything, and she pretend because she was playing childish games. My soul quick when I hear his name. I went from an innocent child to a crazy kid. Knew when I got older I was gonna do a crazy bid. Bullet to his head, but God took him. He had other plans. God had mercy on me, and it changed up. I've been the same from day one. I never changed up.
Fuck is y'all talking about? I ain't being humble no more. Anybody wanna put money up on it, let's do this. And I'm your favorite rapper, let's go. Free my nigga Stretch.
You're now back tuned in into the CEO Row Experience, man. And of course, man, we have my guy, Free Truth Ray in the building, AKA Gas Radio. You know what I'm saying? AKA Row Certified.
Yes, sir, yes, sir.
AKA, no, I'm fucking with you, brother. Man, again, man, it's a pleasure to have you here, man. I'm having a good time, man.
Yes, yes.
I see
yes.
You're having a good time, not only on the CEO Row Experience, but with life at the current moment.
Yeah. How about that,
yeah,
man?
The whole journey. That's a good thing, man. That's a good thing. I want to know, man, what continues to inspire and motivate you to continue to move your empire forward?
My kids. I got a 21-year-old daughter that's in Temple.
Okay, old head. Okay, old head.
You know, I got mad kids.
Okay.
I'm saying like that. You know what I'm saying? You know, I got step kids.
Okay.
You know what I mean?
Yeah.
You know, I'm like a role model, I guess. You know what I mean?
Speaking of that, I just want to let me jump in. Cause you are, regardless if you see yourself as one or not.
No, I am.
Right?
Yes. Yeah. So
how do they feel, real quick, how do they feel about what you do?
They think it's dope. Like I
right.
said, you know, like I right. got a radio show.
Mm-hmm.
So it's like my dad talking about cannabis on the radio. Mm-hmm. I have, you know, a clothing line with autistic bunnies. So my son get to say, you know, hey, that's me. And that's, and you know, and that's Blake. You know what I mean? My two youngest.
Right.
So I get to say, yeah, that's you. You know what I mean? And yeah, y'all going to take over the company. You know what I mean? You going to, look, man, I'm going to get you a shirt. You got to sell some merch at school. Like, you got to start. Mm-hmm. He like, I'm too young to get a job. No, you can work. Mm-hmm. You about to work for me, man. You about to work for yourself because mm-hmm. all this money going to be yours anyway. You know what I mean? I'm just using some of it. That's how I tell my kids. My money is their money. You know what I'm saying? I'm just using some of it for me. You know what I mean? Every now and then I might get a pair of sneaks or a little something for myself. Right. You know what I'm saying? But it's right. really they bread. So,
no doubt.
Yeah, you know, my kids, man.
Continuing to build the legacy.
You know, my daughter, I got a 21-year-old. So she, you know, she one of them kids, man. Say that.
Keep you on your toes.
Yeah, she
yeah,
one of them
no
kids.
Yeah, no motherfucking doubt.
Yeah, like I can't. Yeah, like, no. Like, you know, she look, I get the... I got to make sure my, you know, she looked me up and down like, yeah. Oh, are you, yeah. You know, she makes sure I ain't corny when I, you know what I mean? So yeah, you
can't be corny.
No, my
she said, think you Puff Daddy.
Yeah.
Rev so, Run type, yeah.
So, you know, so I got my daughter's approval when every time I step. Now some, my daughter be thinking she my girl. She okay. Be like, she be looking, yeah. You know what I mean? She be, where you going? Okay, I see you got those on and all. Right. Yo, mind yours.
Yeah.
Like, yeah. You good? So, yeah,
trying
man.
Make sure you ain't corny. Don't be out here being corny, Dad.
I be, yeah, you know what I mean? I be real trying shit. Not to be corny. I be yeah. Rapping.
Right. Yeah, let's get into that. I'm yep. Glad. See, that's what's up. That's the vodka crayon for my man.
Yeah, I'm saying. I be
Free mad. Truth Ray. Yeah. That's what that is. Yeah, good shit. Way to go right into that, because we definitely got to get into that.
Yeah, yeah,
aside,
man.
You know, we didn't hit the media. We didn't hit the clothing.
Yeah.
You know, we doing podcasting.
I be doing a lot, man.
We added music to the situation. You know what I'm saying? As yeah. Of late, I see you, bro. Yeah. I mean, I've been going through a lot, too. Life be lifing. But,
life be
you know,
lifing.
When I tune in, I see Free Truth Ray on a lot of features.
Yeah.
I see Free Truth Ray on a feature with my man, Son of 215.
Yes, yes.
You dig what I'm saying? Shouts out to Son. You dig what I'm saying?
That's my guy. That's my guy.
Yeah.
November 18th.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? My guy, Son of 215, birthday November 18th. Yeah. I definitely will be
Scorpio's
performing.
Scorpio's in the building.
You know what I mean? So, you know, come all. You know what I mean?
That's what's up. And you'll be performing.
Of course. Of course. Yeah, I'll be performing. That's
when crazy. When did Free Truth decide that he wanted to be a rapper? Or an artist.
All right, so I have to be honest, right?
Mm-hmm. Got to be honest.
Yeah. I was, you know, running around with my guy, Mr. Smith, PHL.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Shout out to Mr. Smith.
You know what I'm saying? You know, we from the same neighborhood, you know what I mean? And
what neighborhood is that, brother?
We from Nicetown. Shout out okay. Nicetown.
So, shouts out to Nicetown.
So he I was going to Friday Night Heat or whatever at the time.
Okay.
That's what it was called with my man Ron Murder. He used to have all the artists or whatever.
Shouts out to Ron Murder.
Yeah, you know I mean, bumped into my OG from my hood. He rapped. And one day we was in the car and I was letting him hear some music that I had did, you know, back in the day as a kid. Like, yo, I used to do my thing. You know what I mean? And he was like, yo, man, you know, let's get on something. So me and him, we was just, you know, like, man, you ain't, you know how dudes it. You ain't
you
better
like
than me.
Energy.
You ain't, you ain't, man. What? All right, well, give me the beat. So we did a song called Hot Rounds. Went to the studio. And at the time, I had a cameraman named Who the Shooter. He was my camera guy.
Shouts out to Who the Shooter.
And he shot a dope little clip or whatever. And when we put the clip out, a lot of people just like gravitated to, they gravitated to that verse.
Okay.
Like I'm cool with a lot of people, whatever, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And a lot of people gravitated to that verse of that song. And then we're just like, yo, you heard Free Truth Ray? So we're doing whatever. You know what was going on at that time of the life, in life, whatever. It was like, yo, that's crazy. So then it was like, yo, let's do some more. So,
right.
You know, it was like, all right, well, give me another beat.
And give me another beat.
It kind of went from there. I kind of always had a passion for music. So like, you know, when my guy was like, yo, let's get on this track. It was kind of like a Pandora's box, you know what I mean? And it's open now because, you know.
Because you want it to be open.
Yeah.
Yeah, no motherfucking doubt. You,
yeah.
I mean, it's something that you felt, that you feel like this this is a part of me and I got it.
Yeah. It's
and not only that, I've been knew it because we knew, you know, what you were saying in the beginning of the interview, yeah. That boy, you the biggest motherfucker in the room, right? That other motherfuckers recognized it.
Yeah,
you feel
that?
Me?
How about that?
The other people recognized it, and the spark went off. The seed, the spark went off inside of you.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
Now we doing collaborations.
Yeah, yeah.
We have what, a new EP, a new mixtape, a new album. What's going on with you?
So right now, I'm currently in production of a new show.
Okay.
For my Roku. Subscribe to SDM Flix. I mean, the Road Certified Show, but you know, our YouTube gas station TV, you know, I'm gonna say a couple more weeks where we will be airing a new cannabis series. I'm gonna say parody.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying?
Okay.
And what I wanted to do with that was kind of like have music for each episode, because when I did the Roll Certified Show, I was using other rappers' music or whatever, mm-hmm. and then when you post it on Instagram, they get like, they be shadow banning you, or they be like trying to take it down because they say you don't own the rights to this and all that extra goofiness. So I was like, man, I'm tired of that. Mm-hmm. So because I got the passion for music, I've been in the studio lately. Mm-hmm. You know, most of the music that I've been doing is produced by my girl, and
let's give her a shout out,
like, Lady Steph. Shout out to the Lady Steph. She got a lot of produced dope hits out. That's my guy DJ Weir. We've been at events, and he was he might have been playing something that was produced by her. So. Because she has beats, I look at it like, all right, we got a little in-house situation. I listen to the beats that she has, and then when I'll be on my, I try to come up with a hook first. I don't like writing a rap to a beat without having a hook first. Mm-hmm. So once we get to whatever it's gonna be, then it is what it is. So I'm trying to put out my own music to go on my episodes.
Okay. Your own soundtrack.
Yeah, my
own
soundtrack.
Score.
Yeah.
Yeah.
And because, I feel like I know people.
Right.
I'm somebody, so.
Okay. Okay. That's what I heard. That's just what I heard.
Yeah, I feel like I could reach out to this person or that person, which is happening and people will continue to see, because I take a page from my man Busta. Busta said he ain't never want to do whole songs. Okay. He wanted to do songs with people. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I like that challenge of doing songs with people. Mm-hmm. I feel like if I'm on a song with a certain artist and people already level them to be where they at, then it's like, all right, well, wait till you hear my verse. You know what I'm saying? And when I go to the rappers that I'm cool with, like, ask them to do a song with me or whatever, I let them hear the beat and the hook. And then I let them hear my verse. Cause I don't wanna make you be corny, be like, oh, you did this song with that ball, whatever the situation is, the rappers, they got egos.
Right.
They the most egotistical people in the world.
Do they? I ain't know, Ray.
They the most egotistical people in the world, man. So,
yeah.
Know what I mean?
Say word.
So, hey, okay. You know what I mean? So, if it's me, it's me. It is what it is.
Right, no doubt.
But,
You just letting them know it's worth fucking with. So I'm letting you know the quality of the production, and then I'm letting you hear the bars. Like, so this is something. Or some people gonna feel like they the shit anyway, so they coming for blood anyway on the track.
No, see, all the rappers think, and plus I wanna do songs with rappers that other people know that they is, you know what I'm saying? So it's like, oh, he did a joint with him?
Mm-hmm.
Me hear that joint.
Right.
You know what I mean? So then,
see if you hold your weight.
Exactly.
Right.
You know what I mean? So that's the challenge I get, because I'm 42 and my old heads be like
Jackie Robinson.
They be like, you can't be out here 42-year-old and you rapping and right. And I be like, look, I ain't trying to get no deal or nothing.
Right.
I'm promoting my radio show, my TV show, my
Let me slow you up for a hot second, because I've had I've been doing this thing, this interviewing thing.
All right, talk to me.
I have had plenty of conversations. Is there an age limit on when you can become a rapper, or when you should hang it up wanting or considering being
so
a rapper?
So I was told that, saying? That, hopefully you want to be young and doing it or whatever, right? Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And mm-hmm. that way you building that legacy of it.
Right.
But, music is timeless.
Mm-hmm.
I actually was going to probably am probably that's probably what the name gonna be. Timeless, but music is timeless. So if you could write a song about feelings or a feeling, then that song, it don't matter who it is or who it come from, if it's a good song and it's marketed right, you know what I mean? If somebody write a good song about something and you've been through that or you felt that, then that's just what it is. Right. They got the wave songs. Right. I ain't trying to wave nothing. Right. I ain't doing the beats with I can't do that. Right. And I ain't never drilled nothing. I ain't no drill. Right. I ain't.
So do you see yourself as more? Yeah. Yeah, weird.
I can't.
Just real quick. Do you see yourself more as a lyricist, or are you in it more as a storyteller? I'm here to make songs. Because we know you're not drilling. We know we're not. We're in the same age bracket.
Yeah.
So we are. We understand this.
And I'm gonna say.
So
both.
That would be definitely.
No, I'm gonna say. I'm gonna say both. But I'm gonna lean more to lyricist,
right?
Because
I really
pay attention to my double, triple, entendre. I really pay attention to that. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. I wanna spit a verse, and then you go back and be like, oh, he said, yeah, I said that. Yeah, young boy. That's how I like to look at when I be in the studio with the young boys. Sometimes we getting our little, yeah, put the beat on. I like it when I get the oh yeah, I said that.
So let me ask you this, man. Getting into that, man. See, I love this shit, man. So getting into that, right? So you in the studio, you walk in the studio, it's some young bulls in there.
Oh, I'm picking on them.
You feel like you the old head, you know what I'm saying, with the chip on the shoulder. That,
no,
know.
I'm not the young bull. No, that's not what I do.
Okay.
I'm going to let you know.
I'm
the one that I know my lane. I know my age.
But
I ain't trying to be better than y'all.
No. Okay, cool. No,
I'm not trying to be better than them.
Right.
So what I do is I say, don't let me be better than you, young boy.
Right.
And I might spit some, and then the young boy might spit some craziness. And I'm
right.
Like, ooh. And,
right.
And I might have got, I feel like I got that out of him sometimes. You know what
right.
I'm saying? We
right.
might get the freestyling. I might say my little corny little 16 or whatever right. he might, or it might be, hey, bake right. some. But then the young boy might spit some. I'll be like, ew, you heard what young boy said?
Right.
So sometimes I like being around that. To
the ambiance, the aura of what's
yeah,
the energy.
Hearing the.
Yeah.
You know, hearing the young boys,
yeah.
You know, or the people that I do know that rap, like hearing them, you know, because sometimes the stuff that they freestyle be better than the stuff they wrote down.
Mm. Mm.
Some of them don't know that yet.
Right.
Mm. Some of them don't know that yet. Like, yo, you might right. want
to. Yeah, just record yourself.
Oh, I remember
yourself.
That. I mean,
or just record yourself. Maybe go back.
Yeah,
and
they might want to, you know what I'm saying? Some of them bars like, oh, yeah. I might need to use that. Shoot them.
They need that might help.
Yeah, but I kind of like that. You know what I mean?
So, can we expect any shows coming up for the remainder of 2023? That, you know, you already said, son, November 18th.
So no, I got two. So yeah, I got two big shows in November. I got
okay.
the 18th with Son of 215, Midnight Train. You
okay.
know what I mean? You know that's gonna be crazy. It's gonna be a whole lot of dope artists in the building, a whole lot of dope vendors in the building. Mm-hmm. You know, I got some crazy joints that I just did. So like, I feel confident about my set.
What was the other one? We gave us one. What was the other one? You said it's two. The other date that's in November.
11/25.
Okay.
I'm having a Canna Fest. Shout out okay. K Walker.
Shouts out K Walker.
You know what I mean? We having a whole Canna Fest indoor crazy joint artists all day.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm giving artists the opportunity to rap in front of cannabis vendors and fans. So a lot of events that I go to, it be rappers rapping to rappers.
Mm-hmm.
There's nothing wrong with rapping to the rappers and showing other rappers
no
that
doubt.
You got skills.
Express yourself, brother, express yourself.
Let the rappers.
Express yourself. Yeah.
But we want to rap to the fans.
No doubt.
Yeah, you know I mean, we want to rap to the other non-rappers and see if the non-rappers, you know what I mean? And they, you
yeah.
give them the Instagram and then they
copy that.
Go stream you and all that.
Now you got a fan.
They share, like,
supporter.
And subscribe. Because I be going to some shows and dudes be having some crazy songs. I be like, yo, that song hot.
Yeah.
Why I got to listen to the, I don't disrespect people.
Cool, copy.
The same people, the same songs they keep playing on the mother stations. Right. And it's like, come on, man. They keep playing Shorty. Y'all know who I'm talking about. They keep playing Shorty. Right. She got a million. She on everything. She right. just came out of nowhere. She on right. everything. That's it.
Right.
You know what I mean? So it's like. Yeah. I mean, so it's yeah, like, I, it's like, just, like, so yeah. it's, it be
the
people,
industry plants.
So people, let's say you dude got a set and he got 2-3 songs, right? But one of them joints really hit you.
Mm-hmm.
Now you got somebody and they really listening to that song. Mm-hmm. They might not have liked it the other two, but that one joint killed it. Now you got somebody that just like that one joint. You got a new fan.
Yeah, man.
Trying to put people in the position to do that, man. So, and I'm only doing 3 songs for $50. Sure. I done been to a lot of showcases and they, listen, I pay more than that. Mm-hmm. So because I pay more than that, I don't want you to pay more than that.
Right.
Now you gonna be in a room full of a whole bunch of people mm-hmm. and you gonna pay the low ski and you gonna smoke good, eat good.
Network.
It's too much going on. So 11:25, yeah, I mean, if you know an artist, 3 songs, $50, and they gonna be in front of fans and everybody who got radio ready music, a 98.5 FM, a radio station is gonna be there that's gonna be able to play your song on the radio. Too much going on, man.
Shout out to 98.5, man.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying?
Mm-hmm.
Again, we appreciate you coming on and spending this time here at the CEO Real Experience, man, an experience it has been. I'm definitely feeling your cat, man. You know what I'm saying? Shouts out to all my 420 friends. You know what I'm saying?
They gotta go get Rose certified, man.
They gotta go get Rose certified.
You know what I mean, if you not certified and you smoke, that's a problem. Mm. I feel like everybody should have at least one Rose certified product. You know what I mean? It should be like your ID. You gotta go outside, which you can't go outside without ID. If you smoke weed, you shouldn't be going outside not certified.
No doubt, no doubt, no doubt. Hey, man, as you know, man. Again, it's been a pleasure, bro. Anytime that you would like to come back in the future and discuss anything, you know what I'm saying?
The next time I come back, I got to, you know what I mean? I'm not coming by myself.
Okay.
We going to have a couch.
Right.
Lady Steph got me on this joint.
No doubt.
You know what I mean?
No doubt.
She be saying a whole lot of smart stuff and all that and educating people.
A whole lot of smart
stuff. you going to get educated when you talk to Lady Steph.
No doubt.
You get all theatrics and all that. You know what I mean? If you want to learn something.
Right.
Then, you know, tune in every Thursday, 7 to 9. You know what I mean? WJYN 98.5.
No doubt, man. Shouts out to Lady Steph, man. Shouts out to Rose Certified. Shouts out to my guy, man, at Free Roof Trey.
Yeah,
Free Roof Ray, excuse me. Free Truth Ray. It's the vodka.
I looked at your joint, I said, oh man, I gotta drink some more. I gotta smoke some.
Yeah, brother. Yeah. The vodka crayon for my man, Truth Ray.
I'm going to be at work. I'm glad I work by myself.
Don't even say nothing. It's juice.
I'm just saying, but I work by myself, so can't nobody not be in my business. They don't got to ask no questions.
It's a big-ass Capri Sun. You feel me? But you're doing a really good job, brother.
Thank you very much, yo. And it's crazy.
I ain't trying to get you.
No, it's different for me, man.
I'm glad that's how you did that.
Yeah, you know what I mean? I think it's the drink. You know what I mean?
It's the experience, bro.
I came in fried.
Right.
And it's the drink, and I'm like, you know.
And you enjoying yourself.
Yeah, I can't complain, man. Y'all gave me some grub.
No doubt, man.
That was dope.
Shouts out to R&R Creations for that, man.
Yo, they got grub on their jaw.
Yeah, man. Got the barbecue chicken sliders and the
I bust both of them joints down real fast. I looked left and right, the garlic butter over the roll and all that, man. Oh,
yeah,
I know all that.
I appreciate that. Yeah.
Oh, all right. Well, shout out to her for doing that because I knocked that off. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. So, yeah, you get they got an experience. They got chips, drinks, all that.
Yeah, man, we doing.
When you come to gas station, I'm gonna smoke with you.
No doubt.
If you ain't got no gas, I got you. If you got some gas, we gonna test it. See, we got the diamond tester for weed.
Okay. Yeah, I can't wait. Let me know when I can schedule on to gas.
Yeah, I can test your gas right now.
Yeah.
If you got some gas and you wanna know what it's hidden for,
right.
I got the tester. My lady pulled a boom boom bang out, and I let you know.
Yeah, that's what's up. Yeah, well, I'm looking forward to that, man.
Yeah.
Again, thank you for coming on the CEO Row Experience. Don't go nowhere. Roll
thank
your
you.
L's. But before we go to this brief break, I want to let you know if you would like to advertise or promote your business or music on the CEO Row Experience, you can DM me at CEO Row Experience on IG. If you would like to be a guest on the CEO Row Experience in the live studio audience, you're welcome to come kick it with us. You know I'm going to catch this vibe in the flesh. You can DM me at CEO Row Experience. You dig what I'm saying? Again, thank you to my guest, Free Truth Ray, for coming through, man, and sharing his experiences with us. Shouts out to my man, DJ Weird Nasty, over there on the ones and twos. You feel what I'm saying? And shouts out to everybody that came and supported the CEO Row Experience today. We'll be right back with more of my special guest, Free Truth Ray.
Common sense brought me honor. Excuse me for my cockiness, I'm dashing full of confidence. Queen said she ridder, so I spend her monkey on her. Sometimes she have a monkey fit, my watch got ammonia tick. Haters went George, my love, they so curious. Won't slave, no slave, guess they wanna bury us. Can't break our barrier, we won't become a casualty. Bloodline is factory, such a walking monument. No, I'm not your everyday, hate when you mow me great. Fall regular, never lack, whole status, never slack. Music boy, we on the map, tell them we ain't on our Mac. Kid need a billion rebels, no sleep, never nap. I'ma make the world laugh, touch hearts like I'm Kevin. I'm the kid they wouldn't mention, they skip me cause I'm different, yeah. I'm that kid they wouldn't mention, let's go. Old me, same me, never will they change me. Pray me, play me, never could they hang me. Make me, break me, never I'ma raise. Set the bar, I'm just taking it higher. I don't live for the mall, I live for the higher. The reason they admire, and when you get richer, they say you got priors. They hate how I poly, barrel rolling through turbulent. Prestige and I'm so advanced, they take you to car camp. My chauffeur got car cramp, did this with no advance. Yes, I got Floyd Sands, pardon me, okay, I am so stamped. Raised by the K camp, no Christopher Campbell. I am a stream form, I played on foreign lawn. Watch how I pour it on, my children like get on pie, winning cause I am proud. They love me, they hypnotize. I got them like Billy, huh? They scared gonna kill me, huh? No worry, I'm so calm. Back row with slippers on, don't make me uncomfy. Have you bleeding like Muffly? Don't make me uncomfy. Have you bleeding like Muffy? Old me, same me, never will they change me. Frame me, play me, never could they hang me. Make me, break me, never I'm a
my year. Music boy. Why I say, they need no we got me. Make sure it happens. Hey ho, play watching this nigga.
I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got that sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. I got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce, yeah. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce, yeah. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Got these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up.
Oh, yeah. Nigga, I just touched down. My new watch just bust down. I got you a bitch, I'm getting sucked now. Oh, shit. There I go on that bullshit. Got that 40 with a full clip. Don't come with that bullshit. Wait, I got hella bands on my hands now. I'm the best nigga that's hands down. I got you a bitch on that handstand. Damn. She busted over cause I'm trailed out. 40 got kicked like a field goal. My nigga on freeze, gotta chill, y'all. Tired of these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. And she going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. I got it my own, ain't no hooking up. And she going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce, hey. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. And she going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses, I took enough. I got it my own, ain't no hooking up. And she going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. Hey, I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, now I'm cooking up. I got the sauce, I got the sauce, I got the sauce. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up. Tired of these losses I took enough. Got it my own, ain't no hooking up. She going down, but she looking up. I got the sauce that I'm cooking up.
Yeah. Murder Season Mondays. They call me P. Litty, the hardest working man in the game. Check.
La música de Harry Fry.
Shorty was a model, seen her on the runway. Quiet as a church girl, walking on a Sunday. Said she always working, looking for a fun day. I told her she in luck,
cause it's murder season Monday. We about to turn it up.
It's murder season Monday.
We about to turn it up.
Cause it's murder season Monday.
We about to turn it up.
It's murder season Monday.
We about to turn it up.
Cause it's murder season Monday. Monday, Monday, Monday.
Yeah. Yeah, y'all know what day it is. All the ladies say I'm who they favorite is. All these different flows and these cadences. Change it up on them, now it started making sense.
Shorty, I ain't like she want me to pop.
She said that thing sweeter than piece of rock.
Blazing like a 9mm pop.
In and out quick, I ain't trying me to pop. I start, I'm on my grind, you want me to stop?
What?
Then I holler back once I reach the top. Cause I get hot and pop just like the mama. This bomb on you, you can't touch me any level on this ramen, bruh. Cause I body you, fly out to the Bahamas and kindly count on my commas while laughing all at your comments, bruh. And if you come with that drama, you get the llamas, bruh. All my niggas ride on your wet floors, they'll slide on you. And I be with a bad bitch named Monica, and she keep the nine on her, let her blow like harmonica. And you should've known better, like Monica. Let that thing sing, now your soul gone like Monica. And they can't find a trace, nor a sign of you. And I be up for weeks, can't sleep, insomnia. All I need is two M's and a G, and some gunplay. And I be ready for next murder season Monday.
Yes, yes, yes. You are tuned in to the CEO Row Experience. You're now rocking with the best. Come and get this experience in the flesh. And my dope special guest today is at Free Truth Ray, and he came to get this experience. And as we know, this is the third segment, and in the third segment, we do something with every guest, which is called Finish the Thought. So again, I'll start the thought. It's not difficult, brother. Come, we want to hear what comes first to mind as it flows. You feel what I'm saying, though?
Well, I got the, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah, it's there, man. You the know. Vodka crayon for my man, Free Truth Ray. Yeah, that's what that's called right there. Yeah.
He got me drinking, man.
Yeah. You got me drinking. You see what I'm saying? So we're going to go ahead. We're going to start it off. Yeah. My God, we having a groovy time here.
Yeah, I did.
That's
what
it's about. I don't get to do this often. I have to enjoy this shit and as I'm doing it. You can ask my woman over there. She's over there. Shout out to Miss Rita. You digging? I don't drink a lot.
I don't drink at all unless my girl get it or she supervise. My girl is my personal bodyguard. She got a lot, you know what I'm saying? She's like, you know what I mean?
I don't do that.
If I had a caregiver, but I'm with you. I'm probably my girl, you know what I'm saying? She got me.
It's not that I can't. It's just I'm more of a smoker. I like to chill. But anyway, moving forward, we're going to get into this interview, brother. All right.
Oh, man, you went Hogan on me?
Finish the thought.
You went Hogan on me?
No doubt. I know this is weird, but I really like to. I know this is weird, Ray. But I really like to.
Smoke in the bathroom by myself.
Okay, now hold up. Cause that's not really weird, but I know it can get weird. So I'm gonna ask a couple more questions to see where we can get.
Like you wanted me to get
in. Are you taking a shit
in
the dark?
Yeah, Lord, that's what I'm about to say.
While smoking an L? That's a little weird to me. That's hot boxing. I want to hot box in that particular situation. Per se me.
I'm just saying.
It's a lot going on.
I might have ate something freaky, I might want to smell gas. I'll be having some gas.
Listen, brother, I'm not knocking your thing, because it might make sense to you. Yeah, it might make sense to you. It could be an infant. You cool, you might be on some Rastafari and shit. I don't know, bro. So I can't knock why you do it, but then that would be weird to me, so yes.
Listen, I might think of some bars, you know what I mean?
Now, I'm not smoking in the dark in the bathroom.
Not in the dark though, Ken, and the light be on.
I said. So now you took the weirdness out of it.
You went weird with the freakiness with the and the lights out like.
Yeah, I was just saying it's weird. It's
now
not
somebody
weird.
Think the lights out and they kick in the bathroom and you sitting in the yard talking about all
we
you.
We don't got to worry about that, right?
You know what I'm saying?
Right, we don't got to worry about that, right? Listen. We OGs in this shit. Please do not kick my door.
Yeah.
I'm serious.
Yeah.
That's it. I'm not going to bullshit you. I don't bother nobody. Don't kick my door. But that's what I mean by that. You should be able to take a shit comfortably in your home without somebody kicking on your door, right? I believe that. It's just the American way. I just believe that, you know, you should be able to relax.
I got kids.
No doubt. I give it to you because we spent a lot of time on that. So I'm going to give it to you. But next time,
kids want something while you're taking shit. Kids want something while you're taking shit.
You got to give me something different next time.
All right. Thank you. I'm sorry. That's what you
want. No, you're going to give me one.
Lord, that was a setup.
From time to time, it's good to. From time to time, it's good to.
Oh, man. Yeah. From time to time, it's good to... Yeah. I don't know. I'm going to say exercise, man. I be okay. exercising. I be doing little push-ups. Okay. I got the
you
little...
You got to stay healthy. In case them young boys try, you think you went to grad, so you think you probably still can ball and shit. You be out there. I retire. I want to let you know. I don't ball no more.
So me and my lady, we went to the court one time, and we was shit. Fraught. It was... Yo, I'm going to let you know right now, we was editing our own clips. I can show it to you. It looked good.
I was. You made it look good.
Yeah, I did. But no, I don't. No.
No. That time is coming, going.
No,
brother.
I got. I'm 6'4", and I got. Stepsons is my size. Daughter, my size. You know what I mean. Mm-hmm. I gotta make sure don't nobody try. You know what I mean.
Understood.
It's my crib.
I seen that meme that said, "My daughter's boyfriend." Was allergic to what? Something putting his hands on my daughter?
Yeah.
And he knocked the fuck out. He laid out. He's allergic to putting hands on my daughter.
Yeah.
Yeah. I'm one of them too, brother.
My daughter will call me and be like, I'll be like, don't call me when you want me to beat the boyfriend up, but then y'all be hugging next week. I don't
well,
like
you
that.
Know, come on, man. See, that's, you know, I attribute that now to I pass.
Call me when it's
the
all
woman.
The way over.
I attribute and pass that over to the woman. Your woman knows you best, knows your temperament best. That's
no, nature. My daughter called me with the crying. So I got daughters, so crying work. It works.
Yeah, that's my woman. And if she don't want to deal with it, then I don't really know what to tell you. That, I mean, just, you know.
No, my daughter called me on the three-way with the boy and be like, all right, so say that while my dad on the phone. My daughter out of pocket. My daughter out of pocket.
Damn. My daughter. I was thinking, listen, I said it as if he had a way out. I was saying that he had a way out. You don't have no way out.
Yeah, I'll be like, what did you just call me?
Yeah, you ain't had no way out. I was trying to say it as if you had a way out, but then she put you in the box where you don't have no way out. The joker is on the phone, and she's putting both y'all on the spot. Yeah, so
yeah, my dad on the phone. Now say what you say. You ain't giving me my money. Say that now. I'll be like, oh my God, leave me alone. I love my daughter, man. She like my homie child.
Oh shit.
I got a homie child, man.
Oh, shit.
Yeah, man.
All right. Free truth, right? I could never stop smiling when.
Oh, man. How about when I see my baby daughter?
Okay. Okay. Yeah. What's her name?
Blake.
Okay. Shouts out to Blake.
Yeah,
I made him
baby.
Smile. He's smiling now and shit. All soft and shit. Up here all soft and shit. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Shouts out to baby girl Blake. You know what I'm saying? Daddy loves you.
Yeah, that's my, you know what I mean? She can do whatever.
No doubt.
Yeah.
No doubt.
Yeah.
All right. I give you one more and then we're going to go into the question and answer segment with the audience. Today will be great because...
I was on the CEO Row experience.
Yeah. My guy. You won't catch him off his shit. You feel me? And he finished the John, the vodka crayon for my man, Free True Frey. Yeah. So you already know, man, this is how we coming, man.
I'm definitely, now hold
on. This is how we coming. And he an OG with it because he definitely finished that John. I think that was over maybe 16. What you think?
Now listen, I ain't going to hold you.
That was a lot.
We preach hydration, so I'm definitely, this water is definitely...
No doubt.
Mm-hmm. It's water going down, all of
it. Oh, man. Krish, I appreciate you again, brother, for participating and finish the thought.
You slurring? The drink got you?
It was the water. I think the water just cleared my motherfucking whole passageway.
What?
To be honest. Yeah. If you want me to be real with you, I ain't fucked up or nothing, you know? That cold water went down, brother. You know what I'm saying? But no, it's all good, man. Again, I appreciate you for participating and finish the thought. I enjoyed that. Now we're going to go ahead and open up the floor for the question and answer segment portion of the CEO Role Experience. At this time, if anyone would like to come up and ask a question, please state your name and ask your question. The floor is open now if anyone would like to ask a question. Thank you very much.
Tribe of Levi.
Tribe of Levi. My guy.
Tribe of Levi.
My question was, When you found out about the autism with your children, how old were they, and how long have you been involved with the youth with the autism?
Good question.
I'm gonna say a year, maybe after my son was born. Took him to the doctor or whatever, and I remember is a lady coming to my house, and she was like she was gonna help me with my son, and I was like looking at the lady, and I was looking at what she was doing, and I was like, it's nothing that you're doing with my son that I can't do myself, so why are you in my house? But you know, I didn't set that up. My son's mom did or whatever. But what I did was, I saw what she was doing with my son, and then when she wasn't there, that's kind of what I did with my son all the time. When people, you know, they put the labels on autistic children, most autistic children have an autistic parent. They just probably wasn't diagnosed. A lot of stuff that my son do, I do. So I say that I'm autistic to make, not to make my son feel better, but you know what I mean? To let him know that it ain't nothing wrong with him, because a lot of the things that he do, I do. So. If he autistic, then I'm autistic, you know what I'm saying? And right. I didn't let nobody like try to put a label on him. And I was, you know, I sat with him every day, and I taught him his colors, his ABCs, and this, that, and the third. And I wasn't going to let my son feel like he couldn't, you know, fit in with, you know, kids that wasn't labeled. You know what I mean? And that's kind of how, that's my thing with my son, is just, you know what I mean? I'm gonna make sure that you can, you know, function and at least know how society wants you to act, but then understand who you are and then come to a, you know, a common ground. That's kind of where I'm at with my son right now. He's 12 and, you know, he finding himself. So we finding each other at the same time. So.
Copy that.
Yeah, so I guess I'm gonna say 12 years, you know what I mean? That, you know what I mean? Then I have stepsons that are autistic. So, you know, even when my son's not around, I'm still in the house with, you know, autistic individuals who you gotta learn their patterns and what they like, what they don't like, how they go about things. And so you can know how to talk to them. Because at the end of the day, like, you're a parent. Yo, you got to do these dishes. You got to sweep this. You know what I mean? I ain't got nothing to do with no being no autism, boy. You better do that.
Right.
You know what I mean? So, you know what I mean? It's like, you know, I understand. But,
right.
You know, like I said, we got to come to a common ground. It's things that you have to know how to do. And, you know, hey, go to the store. Count your chain. Everything that... You know, everybody teach their kids. Mm-hmm. So the same things that, you know, that everybody has to, you know what I mean, I hone in on that with my, you know. Okay. Plus, I like the fact that he not real sociable. So I ain't got to worry about him really, you know what I mean?
Getting in the shit?
You know what I mean? No, that don't mean nothing. He's very intelligent in other things. So I hear my son, you know, when your kids are young and you hear them say stuff, mm-hmm. that you ain't teaching, you know what I mean? Like, hold up, you learn that. I ain't, you know what I mean? So there's different levels of it. And you know, the level that my son is on with it is whenever somebody's around him and they speaking or whatever, he absorbs it. So you really got to watch what you say around him. Cause he wants an explanation for everything.
Right.
You can't just tell him something.
Right, you want to know everything.
Well, I want to know why.
Right.
So when I talk to my son, he always gets a full explanation. I'm telling you to do this, and this is why I'm telling you to do it. Now do it. Okay. Or I'm telling you this because this is going to end up to this, that, and the third. Mm-hmm. You want to be that man on the corner with the sign? No, you want to have a job. So when he come to my job and he sit with his dad, say, listen, you want a destiny. You want this. Mm-hmm. When I got money, I said, this is what you want. You don't want to be broke. So I nicknamed my son E-Money. I said, all the girls like boys with money. Yep. You know what I'm saying? If you ain't got no money, they ain't gonna like you.
Hey, well, that's not what we, you know, but I get it.
Yeah, man, you know.
I get it.
Yeah, man, teach, I want him to, right. I conned him into thinking he about to have a job. You gonna come clean up some stuff in my crib, but I'm gonna pay you. Right. But I want you to know you had to earn it.
No doubt. Morals and principles, it doesn't change.
Yeah, man, I'll be trying,
good
man.
Question, brother, that was really good. Would anyone else like to come up and ask a question at this time? And come on, okay, yeah, come on up. State your name and ask your question.
Hello, my name is Cherie. I noticed that you said that you know, your children or whoever may look up for you as a role model. So in your business, is there a place that you see where you're going to, I guess, ultimately employ your children? Is it going to be like a family business, or is your business to promote whatever the dreams of your children may be?
So I'm going to say, of course that I would like to, you know, make what I'm doing more financially, you know what I mean? And of course, yeah, you know what I mean? Of course, you know, I tell my kids that that the autistic thing is already his anyway. So I tell that to my son. So he already in the mindset of that. But my son wants to be a police officer. The exact opposite of me. So I'm doing everything in my power for my son to be a police officer. I tell him right now, you're going to be officer foreman. But I tell him right to be condescending to today's world. If a kid asks my son what he want to be, he want to be a doctor. He want to be a firefighter. Because we know kids don't like cops, right? That don't mean that you can't go on to be that and be a good person and be a good cop. You don't got to be a bad cop. So that's what I'm teaching my son right now. And my son, he know that. When he talked to other kids, no, you know what I mean? So I'm going to support what they do. But of course, whatever I'm doing with my life, of course, that will always, I'm on legacy time right now. So anything that I could do to better my life, better the radio station, better the clothing line, whatever I could do, I'm doing it. I don't know how long you know what I mean? And I want my kids to look back and be like, you know, my dad did this, or yeah, he left me this. So I guess, you know, ultimately everything you do, hopefully you want to leave it to your kids. At the same time, support what they doing, because they might not want to do what I want to do. That don't mean I'm not going to, yo, get up, you got to go to training camp, boy, or whatever they do. I don't know. We going together. I can't wait. You know what I'm saying? I'm going with him.
That's what's up. I got a question before we take it out, because of course we got to get into this performance that you about to give us.
Yeah.
Don't forget that. I know you're like a crayon for my man. You dig what I'm saying? So that didn't wore off a little bit. So yeah, by the time you end this show, we're going to end it right, because my man going to come through and drop these bars for us. You feel what I'm saying? But I want to know, what would the OG Free Truth Ray say to the young Ray? Now that you've been through what you've been through and experienced what you've experienced, you know, the ups and downs, your likes, your dislikes, finding yourself, what advice would you give to your younger self?
Oh, that's a good question. What advice would I give to my younger self? I'm somebody that thought I knew it all, so. Mm-hmm. Tell myself that you don't.
That's fair.
I would tell myself to hang around people that motivate you to do more of what you want to do instead of what they want to do.
That was well put, brother. Again, we appreciate you coming through the CEO Role Experience, man, and blessing us, man. It's CEO Role Experiences, Free Truth Ray, all day. You dig what I'm saying? You already know, man. Make sure you tune in every Monday and Wednesday from 7 to 9 p.m. Make sure you catch my guy on Gas Radio 98.5 FM.
FM, right, Thursday.
Every Thursday from 7
to 9 p.m. Just like you.
You already know, baby.
7 to 9
squad. For some reason, when you do this, it just all clicks.
It's like, you got Monday and Wednesday, and I got Thursday, we running the block. We running, no doubt. You know what I'm saying?
No doubt. And then after Thursday, you can catch me again every Fly Day, man, from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m., man.
Okay.
On the Fly Team
on
Radio.
On the Fly Team.
Hey, powered by Glockaware. Shout out to
Glockaware. So we got the whole block.
We got the whole block, man.
We are shutting the internet down, man.
We are killing the internet. Understand this, man. I'm everywhere, man. We're everywhere, man. It's a whole thing, man. It's a movement.
How about
that?
Yes, we is.
Again, before we slide out, man, I want to thank my guy, DJ Weird Nasty, on the ones and twos. I want to give a shout out to R&R Creations, man, for the appetizers. You already know. Again, before we roll out, plug and let the people know where they can find you at, bro.
You can find me on Rose Certified Everything. I'm talking about www.rosecertified.com. Rose Certified on Instagram, and Rose Certified Music on all streaming platforms. You know what I'm saying? I make music you can smoke to. That's my lane. Know what I mean? I make the music that you can smoke to. I guarantee you. You're gonna listen and you're gonna, you know what I mean? You can find me on Gas Radio with the lovely host, Lady Steph, every Thursday, 7 to 9. I mean, Gas Station Radio, 8 Fit 8. You can find us on SDN Flicks, Roku TV, the Rose Certified Show. I guarantee you, there is no cannabis experience show on Roku TV like mine. I guarantee you. Everybody just sit around and smoke weed. Ain't nobody going where I'm going or doing the type of shows that I got, hands down. You know what I mean? I need to be on them big networks, but it's cool. SDN Flicks is the network, and go subscribe to it.
No doubt, baby. Thank you again for coming on the CEO Row Experience. Don't go nowhere. We'll be right back with a performance from my man Free True Craig. Yay.
Yo, yo, yo. It's your boy Free True Ray. Rose Certified. It's my song, That's a No-No feature, just chill. You know what I mean? Then I got my joint be like,
soon as I wake up in the morning, she and I reach down for my lighter, like my L and take a puff. As I turn and look up at you saying, you ain't rolling up. Cause if you ain't got no weed, then you might as well get up. Got no weed, that's a no-no. Smoke with me, that's a no-no. Smoke for free, that's a no-no. Got no weed, that's a no-no.
Soon as I wake up in the morning and I reach up for my dust, as I reach up for my lighter, like people get out of control. As I turn and look up at you, say,
I see the stock on info,
you ain't got no weed, then you might as well get up, got no weed. That's a no-no. That's a no-no.
That's
a no-no.
No, you can't smoke
with
us.
That's a no-no.
We roll like both of us. You can't get enough. Soon as I wake up in the morning and I reach down for my dust. As I reach up for my lighter like my L and take a puff. As I turn and look up at you saying, you ain't rolling up.
Cause you ain't
got no smoke out there. You might as well get up. Got no weed. That's a no-no. Smoke with me. That's a no-no. Smoke for free. That's a no-no. Got no weed. That's a no-no.
Soon as I wake up in the morning, and I reach down for my Dutch, as I reach up for my lighter, like my ass to butt. Turn and look up at you saying, you ain't rolling up. Cause if you ain't got no weed, then you might as well get up. Got no weed, smoke with me, smoke for free. Got no weed, smoke with me. Smoke for free,
and I'm still not no even weed. Done cooking for
smoke
my
with me.
On my light, I know it sound dumb. Soon as I wake up in the morning and I reach down for my Dutch, as I reach up for my lighter, like my Ellen take a puff. As I turn and look
my
up,
guy just chill.
You ain't rolling up, cause if you ain't got no weed, that's then no-no. You might as well get up. Got no weed, that's a no-no. Smoke with me, that's a no-no. Smoke for free, that's a no-no. Got no weed, that's a no-no. Smoke with me, that's a no-no.
October 23rd, Be Like Me, Free Truth Ray, C Cash, Free, you know what I mean? Produced by my man Iceman Beats.
watch on. My own tee, polo jeans, polo socks on. The Kimbe haters wanna get they block on. Heard I'm getting too much money, get they plot on. Know me get you popped on. Overrated my vodka, used to that popcorn. And then out the spot, so you know I had the cops drawn. Now sell tees, radio, you hear me. Then you at the Roku. Drank old Phil Jack, let me coach you. Cried the money like Shaq when I post you. Never regular, doing what most do. On my grind, about mine like I'm supposed to. Come here, let me coach you. It's in the it's the vodka cream for your man, you know what I'm saying? Like my man said, you know what I'm saying? So yeah, if you ain't been on the CEO Row show, you bugging, come through.
Paid the cost to be the boss. Paid the cost to be the boss. I paid the cost. Look at me, you know what to see.